Hi friends, hope you are fine. In the last video, we discussed about 6 types of ligands or signaling molecules. In this video, let us understand 3 stages of signal transduction. Let's begin with the definition. Signal transduction refers to the sequence of reactions inside the target cell upon binding of ligand to the receptor, leading to a cellular response, ultimately leading to a change in cellular function. Stage 1 is called reception. That means this ligand binds to the receptor or received by the receptor. This ligand binds to the receptor that causes a conformational change in the receptor. This receptor is activated, often activation of this intracellular domain of the receptor. In the case of ligands like peptide hormones such as insulin, the receptors are on the cell surface as it cannot cross the plasma membrane. Whereas in the case of hydrophobic ligands like steroid hormones such as estrogen, it can cross the plasma membrane as it is made up of phospholipid. Therefore, it is having receptor either on the cytosol or inside the nucleus. Stage 2 is called transduction. Upon binding of ligand to the receptor, this domain of the receptor is activated. Then this is followed by sequential activation of many signaling molecules inside the cell, one after other, often by phosphorylation, that means addition of phosphate by kinase enzyme. Then the signal is transmitted further with the help of other intermediate molecules, which are called as second messengers, like CAMP, inositol triphosphate, diacylglycerol, calcium ions, etc., and transmits the signal to target molecule. Second messengers are short-lived intracellular molecules that amplify and relay signals received at the receptor upon ligand binding, such as hormones, to specific target molecules either in the cytosol or inside the nucleus. The signal originated upon ligand binding is transmitted to target molecule inside the nucleus. The sequential activation of relay molecules along with second messengers that is involved in transmission of signal from receptor to the target molecule is called as transduction. Stage 3 is the cellular response. Often the target molecule is a transcription factor, a protein that can directly bind to DNA and activate gene expression, causing transcription followed by translation forming a protein. So cellular response is often activation of a gene leading to its expression that may be involved in cellular responses like cell growth, cell division or cell differentiation. It may be a production of hormone or suppression of a gene, all lead to change in cellular function. Let me summarize. The first stage in cell signal transduction is called reception, where the ligand is received by the receptor. Upon binding of this ligand to the receptor, this ligand undergoes a conformational change. This extracellular domain of the ligand is activated. That further activates series of signaling molecules along with second messengers that transmits the signal from the receptor to the target molecule by sequential activation, which is called as transduction. And finally, this target molecule activates or causes expression of a gene leading to a cellular response, often leading to cell growth, cell division, or cell differentiation. These are the 3 stages of cell signal transduction. In the next video, we'll be discussing about cell surface receptors. Till then, take care, stay blessed. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com.